Hi, this is Russ Andersson. In this tutorial, I'm going to be talking about the graph editor's Deglitch tool, which is a way to help clean up trackers to eliminate small bumps that can result in bumps in the camera path. Now, any given tracker generally isn't going to create too much of an impact on the camera path due to the averaging over all the different trackers, but you know, a small and significant bump can produce something that you can see, so we'd like to be able to eliminate those to produce the best quality results. So you do that in the graph editor, and it's a complementary and kind of more finesse sort of tool than the cleanup trackers, which kind of gets everything at once, kind of in a fairly simplistic way. The cleanup, the deglitch tool lets you get good, super detailed control over what it is that you want to do. So we're going to work with this shot here, and you'll notice that there's a lot of brick textures here that typically result in problems for auto trackers just because there's a lot of repeated textures and you can jump from one instance of the texture to the next. So we're going to run the auto tracker here. But the deglitch tool is perfectly good whether you're working with supervised trackers or auto trackers. So let's go to the graph editor. We're actually going to get a camera and graph editor view. So we've got something like this. We're just going to change the sizing a little bit to give us something more to work with, and our deglitch tool is down here, and you'll see the tool tip shows that there are a bunch of different things you can do with it. The first thing we're going to do is just select all of the trackers, and we're going to do a little setup here, starting off with double-clicking the zoom tool on the error channel so that we've just auto-scaled the view here for the error channel so that our worst case error is up here at the top, so you can see kind of what's the worst thing there. And we're going to turn off the display of the figure of merit curves. We don't really need those. And we'll go and increase the gain of the two velocity curves just to make it a little easier to see what's going on. So next, let's go and change the sort order to sort by error, so that now we do really have the worst tracker up at the top, and you can see what that is. That one isn't kind of rocket science. So let's go and look at what's going on. Here I'm just zooming in with the mouse wheel, but let's turn on the pan to follow mode. That's easiest to do with the 5 key. So now the camera view is being panned continuously to track that particular selected tracker. And if you look carefully, you can see here's the tracker here. It's about, you know, two blocks to the right of this one darker block. And then as you scrub through it, it jumps over to a different copy of the brick pattern. So what we really like to do here is right around here, it starts to jump. So it's good up to there. But this frame here, it's jumped over, and you can see that from the velocity curve here. All of a sudden, there's this big jump in the velocity as it goes off to the right. So we're going to use our deglitch tool, and I'm going to hold down the shift and just click on that velocity spot up there. I could have clicked on any of the curves as long as it's on that frame where we want to split it. And you'll see now that we've got a tracker beforehand. This is the original tracker, and we've got a split one now that is, you know, after that split mark. And you see the error now is low. The split operation does a quick zero-weighted tracker recalculation of the error for the tracker, so we can take a look at what's happened. And you can see that that guy is now really nice. You can see that up in the camera view as well. The guy on the other side, however, still needs some work. And really, the part after it locks onto that final spot that's good, but what comes before is not so helpful. So we'll just do the same thing. I just shift click, and now I've got, you know, yet another tracker here at the end. That's like 102 split one. And you've got this intermediate tracker that's not really so helpful. So I'm going to hold down Control and just run over that particular tracker curve there. That's with the left mouse button down. So that's the temporary isolate mode. So I have just that one particular tracker selected. So it's sitting up there and moving around. And though we've got some error for it, it's not really anything useful, and it corresponds to some position off in the distance, something like that. So we're just going to delete it. And now we've just got the initial tracker that's good, and we've got the final tracker that's good. So we've cleaned that particular situation up. So that's showing you how you can use that split mode of the Deglitch tool to fix various problems that you might see. So let's go and look at an actual deglitch sort of thing. So I'm just going to hold down the Control key to do that isolate. Let's take a look at this particular bump. Here it is up here in the camera view again. And as I scrub through there, you see that just for that one frame, it jumps off to a slightly different position. So this one particular frame is bad. Now, in this particular scene, you know, we've already solved it, and you know, you've got the error curve that's showing you pretty much what's going on. So we can use the deglitch tool right here, and that's pretty clear. If you're working just from a supervised trackers that haven't been solved, then you don't have that error curve yet, but you might look at the velocity curve and see, oh, there's a problem here. So you can actually select either on this peak or that peak there, and the deglitch tool figures out what's going on and takes out the right spot. So I can go and just click there, and it's actually figured out which frame needs adjustment, and it's gone and computed a new location for that one particular frame. I'll just undo that so you can see. Again, if I'm go to sit on that frame, and now I just click on that again, you know, it's going and computing based on the average of the frame before and after, you know, where the tracker should be. So that gives a reasonable location for it. And we've cleaned up that particular problem area there. So let's take a look at something else. Again, I'll hold down Control, and you know, here you see a situation where the very beginning of the track is a little bit off, and then it locks on. And you know, this sort of thing is fairly common, just because the places that are getting tracked are, you know, often appearing from behind some object, or coming in from the edge of the screen, or disappearing off screen, or whatever. So you can just go and click on those beginning frames. So I can do that either on the error curve there or on the velocity curve there, and have that get cleaned up. So, you know, yeah, you can see that you can just work your way through all of this and slowly clean up all of the issues. That's just a Control A. And with a little bit of work, you can really get things cleaned up. So I can, you know, here's a situation where there are a bunch of frames in a row. So I can either do that, or of course I could do a split and then delete one of the trackers. So you can do it either way, whichever you want. And you can do it in some cases without even really looking too hard, just because you you do have a lot of different trackers available. You know, if you're doing a supervised track and you don't have very many trackers, then you want to be maybe a little more careful about what it is that you're going to delete. So you can run through this process, and you know, you wind up then with much lower errors. Here, let's just fix this one too, and that may help that one. That's another split also. And you know, once you've done that, you can go back to the solver panel, and let's see if we can do this. Also, let's take a look at just unselecting those. Here are our different velocity curves. So now I can go and resolve it. And you know, as I do that, you know, you can see that the amount of bumpiness, you know, especially you can see there's a big bump there. You know, the amount of bumpiness goes away, and you've cleaned up some of the problem areas, which of course is the point of this exercise. So hopefully this gives you some ideas now what the tools are, how the Deglitch tool can help you clean up these things and be able to eliminate just those little, even single frame bobbles that you just might see go by and say, hey, what was that? So you can just go in the graph editor, be able to take a look at the curves, find out what the issue is on that particular frame, and then just easily take it out without even going even to the tracker panel to do that. So hope that helps, and thanks for watching.